Whereas before, I could happily walk around the shop. If I wanted a little extra treat, I could put it in, not panic. And now I get to a till. If I haven't got a list and stuck to that list, I'm now praying when I am at the till, because I'm like, I dread to think how much this is going to cost me.
I have two in that I need childcare for, and I literally work to pay my childcare. That is it.
I know that, you know, after the mini budget a year and a half ago, well, we've all seen it, rents and mortgages go through the roof.
I'm double bluff.
Is that a mortgage?
Yeah.
How on earth do you manage with that?
Cut out everything else in life. It's like, yeah, pay my electric this month, leave it next month, do a payment plan for the following month, pay Bob and Pete, pay Paul.
If I do become Chancellor, I'll be the first ever female Chancellor of the Exchequer. We've both got young kids. I know we're on better wages with the jobs that we do, but we work really long hours. We know how expensive childcare is. We're lucky that our mum and dad are able to help us both a bit. We've made a commitment to have free breakfast clubs at all primary schools, and we've also committed to 100,000 new nursery places at schools. I know it's tough at the moment. We won't be able to fix everything straight away. I know that it's a real mess what I'm going to inherit if I get the job, but we are determined to start to make things better for working families like all of yours.
But also, thank you for acknowledging that when you were saying that, you know, that you do earn more than us, and but your priority is still that, because a lot of MPs will talk down to or whatever, and they're earning, and they have so much money, and I'm like, I can't relate to you. But when someone acknowledges, look, I understand, like, yeah, I'm on a higher pay thing, but I'm listening to you, that makes a difference. Yeah.